So back with the vote via Zoom with Councillor Robert Nemeth, Conservative, Councillor Fuddy, Wishwall, Brighton and Hove City Council. Welcome back. And we are going to be chatting a bit more about local issues, CCTV and, you know, people disposing of waste illegally. Tell us a bit about that.
Okay, so we talked in the first half about our big exciting proposals for, you know, the crown jewels of the city. But these are, I think we're going to talk about now some of our smaller proposals, which are going to have a huge effect on people's lives. So one of them is, I think it's common knowledge locally that, sadly, Brighton and Hove has been neglected in terms of cleanliness, you know, vandalism, fly tipping, these sorts of issues. And although the council has talked tough on some of these subjects, you're just not seeing cases solved. So it's pretty obvious when you look at the most fly tip bins that they're being fly tipped every single night without fail. So a mattress appears every night by certain bins, you know, a large chair, a lamp, you know, general rubbish just being left by these bins. It looks disgusting, and you wouldn't want one of these next to your own house. And I can see one out of my own window now, and it's got rubbish next to it. And in any central area in the city, people complain about this all the time, and it affects their lives in a big way. So you could just you know, sit a van outside these bins and literally wait 8 hours, and in that time a few people would fly tip, and you would collect fines of, say, you know, if you did £200 or £300 a go every single night, you'd be making quite a substantial profit. But we're taking this further by, instead of saying just hiring a couple of guys, sitting them in a van, getting them to wait, we're saying buy a whole series of different CCTV cameras, you know, £50,000 worth, so serious amount of money for, you know, mobile CCTV, and placing them, you know, as and when demand, you know, requires it, near bins, near areas that we know fly tipped. In my own ward, Ingram Crescent suffers particularly from fly tipping around the bins. I mean, all sorts of things pop up, you know, washing machines, commercial waste, and we just want to tackle it and make money off the back of the fines. Because, I mean, I have no sympathy whatsoever for people who fly tip. So the idea is that ultimately those who are fly tipping pay for it, which I think is very reasonable.
Yeah, what do you think the reaction is going to be? I know that Dawn Barnett, Councillor Dawn Barnett, has been successful in the past campaign for CCTV in Hangleton, hasn't she, there by the Grenadier?
Yeah, Dawn's great. So this is an extension of this kind of thing. I mean, everybody hopefully agrees that the city looking disgusting, as it sadly has been allowed to, is not good news. You know, it ruins people's lives, and it puts tourists off, which in turn affects businesses, and it's dirty. There's all sorts of health issues. So, I mean, I don't think I'd have much sympathy with someone who was against catching fly tippers. I mean, it's something we've just got to crack down on if we want Brighton and Hove to look pretty again. I mean,
yeah,
I think it stands to reason.
Moving on to foam masks and dog bins. What's the story there with those two items?
Well, the story with the foam masks is that 5G masks are popping up all the time now.
Yeah.
It's a reality of our times, and despite residents having health concerns, the legislation doesn't allow them to be opposed. So I think a 5G mask rollout is just inevitable now, especially with you know, a huge demand increase for Zoom calls and, you know, Skype meetings and the like. You know, we need more internet capacity now and fewer large offices. So these masks are going to pop up. It's inevitable. So we're saying try our best to make them prettier. Plant trees around them. We need trees anyway. So if you're going to put them anywhere, put them in front of these big, ugly masks, and also try and disguise some of these masks a bit more like trees. And that's, you know, I think that's
makes common sense.
I don't think there'd be many people against that. Bins is fairly obvious. I mean, bins is a bit of a boring subject really, so maybe we don't, but I mean, there are lots of bins missing, there are lots of broken bins, there are lots of vandalised bins. We just want that sorted, and it's something that a decent council would be doing anyway. I mean, it's embarrassing in a way that we have to put in our budget proposals do simple things, because the administration should be pushing this themselves. But that's sadly not the case.